Hey astronomers, I have a question for you. Where do you live? Maybe you said a house or apartment. Maybe you said the name of your town or city. Or maybe you even said your state or country. Think about when you write down your address, what comes first? That's right, your house or apartment number. What's after that? The street you live on, followed by the city that your house is in. Then you might write the specific state or province you live in, followed by the country. Notice how we begin with the smallest descriptor for where we live, our house. Then we work outward to larger descriptors, like our city or town, state, and country. You could even think about the continent your country is on, or even the entire planet that it's all a part of. Earth! But why stop there? It's time to blast off into outer space to learn about how our entire universe is arranged. Throughout this video, keep in mind how incredibly small we are within our vast and expansive universe. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to describe the arrangement of the universe and understand how light years are used to measure distance. Just like how your home is on a street, in a city, in a country, everything in space fits within a larger structure too. The entire Earth may seem huge to us, but cosmically speaking, it's just a tiny speck in space. Let's zoom out even further from Earth and think about what larger structure our planet might belong to. Earth is a planet that orbits the Sun along with seven others. This collection, or system, of planets that all orbit our Sun has a special name in astronomy. It's called a solar system. Our solar system is one of countless solar systems in space, and each one is huge. You might remember from our last unit that Voyager 1 is traveling at a pace of 1,000,000 miles a day and still won't reach the end of our solar system for thousands of years. But where will it be when it does? Let's keep following the classification pattern we've been using. We know a collection of planets around a star is called a solar system. What about a collection of solar systems? A collection of stars, solar systems, and everything in between is called a galaxy. Think you can name the galaxy that Earth is in? I'll give you a hint. It shares a name with a candy bar. Our solar system is part of the Milky Way galaxy. Now, this is where it gets truly crazy. How many stars do you think are in our Milky Way galaxy? What did you guess? Thousands? Millions? 1 billion? Astronomers estimate that there are over 100 billion stars just in our galaxy. There are many different types of galaxies, which you'll get to explore in more detail later. The Milky Way is a spiral galaxy, which is a galaxy where most of the stars are found within arms that all rotate around a large mass in the center. Earth is located within one of the arms. So, if you've ever heard the phrase, "You're not the center of the universe," I'm sorry to say, but they were right. We're not even at the center of the galaxy. Let's take a moment to recap. What classifications have we learned so far? Pause the video and fill in the blanks in your lesson notes. Great! So far, we've learned that Earth is part of a solar system, and that solar system is part of a galaxy. Let's try to visualize how absolutely gigantic the Milky Way galaxy is. Remember that there are over 100 billion stars in our galaxy, and our Sun is just one of them. Our solar system is such a small part of the galaxy that if you can imagine the Milky Way as a huge beach that is 31 miles across, our entire solar system would be the size of one single grain of sand. But guess what? We're not done yet. Remember, the Milky Way is just one of countless galaxies in space. The last and largest classification astronomers use is the collection of all galaxies known as, you guessed it, the universe. The universe is defined as all existing matter and space considered as a whole. So, in other words, everything that exists. The universe is so giant that we can only currently measure a portion of it, known as the observable universe. Astronomers are very confident the universe is quite a bit larger than what they can currently observe, but aren't exactly sure how much larger. Let's use our grain of sand analogy from before to visualize the immense size of the universe. Imagine again that our entire solar system has been shrunk down to the size of one single grain of sand. The observable universe would be a beach over 23 million miles across. But as massive as that is, the observable universe is only a part of the entire universe. Why do you think there is a limit to how far astronomers can observe? Pause the video here and write your answer in your guided notes. If you said it's too far away for us to see, you're on the right track. To understand why we can only observe the universe to a certain point, we need to understand a little something that you may have never thought about too much. Light. Light is the reason we can see anything at all. We can see the light from stars directly, and we can observe planets and other objects in space by observing the light that reflects off of them. But just like anything else that moves, light takes time to get from one place to another. This is not really noticeable here on Earth because light moves so incredibly fast, it seems instantaneous to us. How fast does light travel, you ask? Let's compare it to driving in a car. A car speeding down the highway might go up to about 80 miles per hour. That's pretty fast. Now, prepare to keep your brain inside your head. Light travels at a speed of about 670 million miles per hour. To put into perspective how incredibly fast this is, that means that light could travel around the entire Earth 7.5 times in a single second. I wonder how much a speeding ticket for going 670 million miles over the speed limit would cost. Yikes! Now that we know the speed of light, we can learn about the most common measurement astronomers use when measuring distances of objects in space. The light year. It may seem weird that I said a light year is a measure of distance, but let me explain. Objects in outer space are so unbelievably far away from Earth and from each other that astronomers use the distance that light travels in a year as a measure of distance. So, if light travels at 670 million miles per hour, that means a single light year is almost 6 trillion miles. And guess what? The next closest galaxy to the Milky Way is 25,000 light years away. Now, this brings me back to the reason scientists have a limit to how much of the universe they can actually observe. There are galaxies in space that are so far away that the light from their stars has not had enough time to reach Earth yet. Try to imagine how far away something has to be for its light to have not even reached Earth yet, traveling at 670 million miles per hour. The universe is absolutely gigantic. Now let's recap what we learned on our trip through the universe today. You now know that Planets are part of solar systems, which are part of galaxies, which are part of the universe. Astronomers use this system to describe the universe's structure. Objects in space are so massive and so far away from each other that astronomers use light years to measure distances. We can't observe the entire universe because light from incredibly distant objects hasn't reached Earth yet. Every single day, as light continues to hurtle towards us at millions of miles per hour from the distant edges of the cosmos, the observable universe grows. This means that there are constantly new and exciting things to learn and discover about the universe we live in, even from the tiny little speck in space that we call Earth. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson as you continue your journey into the universe. And always remember, you are out of this world.